It's unfortunate that all these things is happening to police. And I really blame the police for not taking actions and some of the senior officers who are too greedy to themselves. It is unfortunate that police who claim to know their rights and knowing what they are doing, they are allowing this kind of a thing happening to them. Government or the police itself will connive with some people to work under police pension form as civilians. At the end of the day, they will end up doing as they like. And that is why you see the corruption in the police have no limit. No, there is nothing they will do now to stop corruption in the police because some people have already been deteriorated with the, in fact, corruption is already in their blood. When you see people struggling to live a comfortable life, when you see a policeman trying to make sure that he builds at least a normal house that he will live with his family at the end of his retirement after 35 years, you begin to ask yourself, how will that person be able to survive that kind of stress for 35 years? There is no police officer, you will tell me, in Nigeria that his salary is enough for him to build at least a four or five bedroom flat that will be comfortable for him to live with his family, even if you have two or three children. It's because the salary is too meager. Are you talking of house? Are you talking of food? Are you talking of health? Are you talking of education? Are you talking of... There are so many things as a father or as a mother, a serving police officer, you must do to your family to make sure that they are comfortable. So it's unfortunate to see that after serving Nigeria for 35 years, some people are still protesting. Retired police officers are protesting for their rights. You can imagine the so-called Nigerian police contributory pension. What is contributory pension? DSS of yesterday are taking more than a retired DSS today is taking better and even more than a retired superintendent of police. It's true. Because you can see that a mate of yours who retired as 2-star, 3-star, or even inspector is taking below than what a retired DSS personnel in their capacity is taking, even in the Nigerian Army. So after suffering, some set of people will sit down and say, you must produce this, you must produce that. Your letter of appointment, your promotion letters, and your ID card of retirement and all of that. This is so shameful. This is so shameful and a disgrace to Nigerian police. Let us be sincere. Why is it that you see people struggling to make sure that their family are in order? Why is it that you see people, even if they say corruption is not something that a police officer should find himself doing or to be corrupted, you will find out that when you go to divisions, you go to different places, you see people are corrupt to a certain level. Some people are not corrupt because they want to be corrupt, but because of the system is bad. They want to go and build at least a good house. There is nothing wrong for a police officer to live in a comfortable apartment. There is nothing wrong for a police officer to drive a good car. There is nothing wrong for a police officer to take his children to a better school, to give them a better education. There is nothing wrong with a police officer to look clean. But it's unfortunate that police officer will also take his own salary to buy a uniform. And how much is it? It's too bad and wrong. Honestly speaking, we are not happy about the situation. The fact that we are just looking up to God to help us. But the system, the government of today is not helping matters. Nigerian police have been promised since 2015 that our salary will be increased till today. Nothing has happened. Retired police officers are still protesting on the streets. How are you encouraged as a serving police officer to be happy to do the job? You cannot be happy. There is no way you'll be happy. Why? Because you see what is happening to your parents, you see what is happening to your colleagues, you see what is happening to your brothers, you see what is happening to your sisters after their retirement. They still go on the street to beg for their own money. This is too bad. Very, very bad. By now, I expect the president and the government of today should have taken example of what happened during NSAS protests. Even if it's just say, let me do it, in order to put smile on their faces, they would have increased police salary. So that at least that grievances, that lack of morale, that lack of some people's competence or willingness to do the job, at least it will reduce. But every day, They are working on the welfare. They are working on the welfare. They are working on the welfare. For how long will they continue to work on the welfare of the Nigerian police? And apart from that, the Police Act and Regulation says there is no police officer that is given any chance for him to run any business. My brother, my sister, is it the 45,000 naira they pay you as a constable that will be enough for you? If you are a corporal, how much is your salary? If you are a sergeant, how much is your salary? Even an inspector of police, how much is your salary? Comparing to the goods, the commodity in the market, go and ask how much is bag of rice, your children's school fees. The barracks are not enough for you and I to stay. If you are renting an apartment outside, go and check how much will be your house rent in a year. Your wife, yourself as a police officer, your children, sickness, that one is compulsory. Nobody is praying for bad, but sickness, that one is normal. You must go to hospital. You must pay your children's school fees. You must do this and that. And apart from that, you have your own biological parents. You have your in-laws. You have other relatives. So how is the Nigerian government encouraging police to do their job? Living in dilapidated barracks, divisions not well equipped. So go to the north and see what is happening. The attack division, in fact, I don't think if there is any outpost again existing within Kaduna, most of Kaduna, part of the state, what are they called, Niger State, and Sokoto, Zamfara, most of the outpost is no longer active, it's not even working. Talk more of division. Division, every division now is not divisional headquarters. Nothing is working there. Any small attack, everybody will just mate. We are not equipped. That is the truth. And somebody will sit down and be telling you that you can bring your letter of promotion, declaration of age, first letter of appointment, and photocopy of your ID card before they will give you your rights. Something you serve for 35 years. It's too bad. See, we cry for ourselves because we have been crying to the government that the government is not doing the needful. So we have to cry for ourselves and pray to God to help us because nothing is happening. We keep talking and talking and talking and talking. Nothing is happening. When you talk now, the IG will go and say, I'm working on your welfare. Of course, we know that the IGs are trying their best. And we know they are making sure that the junior officers are doing well. But honestly speaking, they need to work hard more and more. Because from constable to inspector, they are the ones doing the job. That is the truth. So we are not happy. But there is nothing we can do. We are only praying so that one day things will certainly change. If the government is know what they are doing, they should do the needful. Not promising and promising. For how long will they keep promising? And things are not going well. It's too bad. So the comfortability of your security is the best thing that you should do. Why? Because there is no country that survives without security. Any country without standard security is, in fact, the country is bound to fail and fall. That is it. So the government should do the needful. They should make sure they do the right thing because they have demoralized the morale of so many officers. A lot of people don't even want to go and work where they will go and, you know, combat crime and do so many things. Some people are even tired of so many things. Just that, let me not just go and sit down at home and say there is no job. That is it. So it's too bad. It's too bad. The pain is there, but it's too bad. Honestly, it's too bad. But when you talk now, some people will begin to kick against it and say this and that. Or they will say, be careful here and there. My brother, in death, there is no carefulness. You are dead, you are dead. The living will continue. Highest, they will say this and this and that. But my brother, when you die, you die. That's all. So it's too bad. They should give them their rights. Do not allow them to keep protesting over what they have suffered for. This is their fundamental right, which they have suffered for. So it should be given to them. You can't tell me that all this while they have been in service, you don't have their details. They should be able to have their details so that tomorrow, in case if something happened and they run to them, they will be able to sort it out for them. Not for you to say, after how many years, you now say, from so-so year to so-so year, that they are the ones that are going to do this. What happened to the ones that have passed? How about? Sorry, the Allah. I'm going to go to the house.